you know, something like this, you know, hazard, it could still, you know, like, still look like if you're talking within the language of abstract expressionism or stuff like that. So, I must admit I'm still trapped within that language of painting.
Is it possible that I should still be painting and not be able to paint?
I don't know. I've been trying to do that.
Can we just sort of talk about the, when you make an exhibition like this, do you plan it from an early stage as an entity?
You mean the whole exhibition?
Oh, yes. So, yes. At what point did you decide what this exhibition would look like?
As soon as I get to the exhibition space, I look at the space and I say, maybe it's a little bit more, something. It's too wide.
Right, so it's not until you arrived here that you decided to paint the green
walls. I think because if it's too wide, it will put too much attention into the paintings themselves.
Is that a bad thing?
Huh?
Is that a bad thing?
I don't know.
Questions. So you have painting with various arches. Now a very simple painting. These two ones, which are quite rough, and very smear paintings, the marking management. Do you normally like to have that variety of work?
It depends. Really, depends on the space. It depends on. In the hospital while my wife was recuperating from an operation.
So they were in the waiting room? You drew them in the waiting
room? No, in the hospital room, I think so.
So this part explains why you're having quite a coherent
room? Yeah, like a series, because I did them at Ocampo.
So in a sense, they are one unit, whereas the paintings are very, very almost legitimate
French back. Yeah, right back to the very visible.
Can we go back to 20 years ago to now, the stuff on that first painting? The paintings then were very different. Maybe we should just pass around a couple.